Okay, students, welcome to the next session, that is new syllabus. We are discussing about chapter 2, sexual reproduction in flowering plants. In this chapter, last class we have seen megasporangium, that is ovule. In that, new cellus we have discussed already. So, but here the new cellus definition specifically they will ask in annual exams. See, the new cellus is a multi-layered. The multi-layered main part of the ovule is called new cellus. See, multi-layered. See, like this way will be there. Like this way. Here, this region, here, the multi-layered main body of the ovule is called new cellus. This is called new cellus. New cellus. The new cellus, this new cellus is covered by one or two layers. The new cellus is covered by one or two layers. These two layers are called integuments, integuments, outer layer, inner layer. These two layers collectively called integuments. Okay, that is new cellus. Next, another definition is perisperm. See, it is also very, very important definition, perisperm. As the endosperm develops, the developing endosperm utilizes new cellus is completely. See here, as the endosperm develops, in some seeds, the new cellus is completely utilized by the endosperm. Listen carefully. This new cellus completely utilized by the endosperm in some seeds. That is, most of the seeds, it is happens. Okay, in most of the seeds, the developing endosperm utilizes the new cellus completely. Okay, but in very few seeds, that is banana, black pepper, 4 o'clock plant, etc. In these plants, the developing endosperm, forms a thin layer. Around the developing endosperm, the new cellus forms a thin layer. That thin layer is called perisperm. See, for example, this is endosperm. In majority of the seeds, the developing endosperm utilizes new cellus. This new cellus is utilized by the developing endosperm. See, this new cellus is utilized by the developing endosperm. This is what happened in majority of the seeds. But in some peculiar seeds, that is banana, 4 o'clock plant, rhizome, ginger, etc. In these plants, so this endosperm cannot utilize this new cellus. This new cellus forms thin layer around the developing endosperm. This thin layer, new cellus forms a thin layer around the endosperm. This is called perisperm. Okay, that's all. It is important definition. In developing seeds, the new cellus is utilized by the endosperm. That is what happens in most of the seeds. In some peculiar seeds, the developing endosperm cannot utilize this new cellus. The new cellus persists as thin membranous layer around the endosperm. Okay, that's all. That is called perisperm. Example, banana, ginger, 4 o'clock plant, black pepper, etc. That is. Next, here on that day only we discussed that inside the megasporangium, there is one megaspore mother cell or embryo sac mother cell. One megaspore mother cell or embryo sac mother cell that forms embryo sac. So that is already we have seen that. See, this is called embryo sac. This is what we will call embryo sac. Embryo sac. This embryo sac contains various parts. So parts of embryo sac. Parts of embryo sac. What are the parts are present in embryo sac? Those parts, first one is nucellus. Nucellus. See, the multilayered main part of the ovule is called nucellus. Two, integuments. Integuments. There are two integuments are present. Outer integument, this is called outer. This is called inner. Outer and inner, these two are collectively called integuments. These two layers protect the ovule from external environment. Two integuments. Third one is, see here, this region is called chalazal end. Chalazal end. This region is called micropyle. Micropyle. So opposite to the micropyle, there is another end that is called chalazal end. Opposite to the chalazal end, micropyle. See, chalazal end region, embryo sac contains three haploid cells. That is antipodals. Those three are 1, 2, 3 antipodals. Okay, that's all. Next, fourth one is micropyle. Micropyle. Okay, this is called micropyle. This micropyle, it is a small pore through which pollen tubes are entered. Pollen tubes are entered through which. See, at the time of pollen grains germination, pollen tubes are formed. That pollen tube is entered inside through micropyle. This hole is called micropyle. Micropyle, it is a small pore through which pollen tubes entered inside. Okay, that's all. Next, fifth, two polar nuclei. See, middle of the embryo sac, two polar nuclei. Each one is haploid. Two polar nuclei. And sixth one is two synergids. Here, these two are called synergids. Middle one, egg. Two synergids and one egg cell, which is haploid in nature. These are all the parts are accommodated in embryo sac. These are all the parts of embryo sac. Okay, that's all. This is the embryo sac explanation. So now we will see how this embryo sac is formed. So embryo sac is called female gametophyte. Pollen grains is called male gametophyte. Similarly, embryo sac is called female gametophyte. How embryo sac is formed in angiosperm? That is what here we will see. Megasporogenesis. Megasporogenesis. See, the process of formation of megaspore from the megaspore mother cell is called megasporogenesis. See, microsporogenesis we have seen. The process of formation of microspore or pollen grains from the microspore mother cell is called microsporogenesis. Similarly, megasporogenesis also like that only. The process of formation of megaspore from the megaspore mother cell is called megasporogenesis. Okay, so megaspore, it is called functional. This is formed from megaspore mother cell. So the megaspore mother cell is a diploid cell. Megaspore mother cell is a diploid cell. See, megaspore mother cell, this is megaspore mother cell, which is diploid, contains dense cytoplasm and a large prominent nucleus. Around this new cellus, this is called new cellus is present. So this nucleus undergoes meiotic divisions and forms four megaspore cells. 1, 2, 3, 4 megaspores. Four megaspores. See, one megaspore mother cell, it is megaspore mother cell, which is diploid in nature and contains dense cytoplasm and a prominent nucleus. So this prominent nucleus undergoes meiosis divisions and produces four megaspores. Out of these four megaspores, three megaspores are degenerate. Only one megaspore is functional megaspore. It contains dense cytoplasm and nucleus. So the process of formation of megaspore from the megaspore mother cell is called megasporogenesis. Is called megasporogenesis. Okay, that's all. So like this way megaspore is formed. So four megaspores are formed actually. Out of these four megaspores, three degenerates. Only one megaspore is functional. This megaspore undergoes growth stage and divides by mitosis and produces 8 haploid celled female gametophyte, that is called embryo sac. See, this only one functional megaspore. This one functional megaspore undergoes growth phase and divides by mitosis and produced 8 haploid cells. 8 haploid celled stage is called female gametophyte. Okay, so now we will see female gametophyte. See here, female gametophyte. The functional megaspore undergoes growth phase and divided by mitosis and forms female gametophyte. The structure thus formed through mitosis divisions, that structure is called embryo sac. This is also called female gametophyte. Female gametophyte. Okay, that's all. So here, the process of development of female gametophyte or embryo sac from one functional megaspore, is called monosporic development. Monosporic development. Monosporic type of embryo sac. Why it is called monosporic? Mono means only one megaspore. Only one megaspore undergoes growth phase, divides by mitosis, and produced 8 haploid celled embryo sac. So this type of embryo sac are formed from one functional megaspore. Such type of embryo sac is called monosporic development. This kind of development of embryo sac is very common in polygonum type of plant, knotweed plant. Knotweed and polygonum type of plants. In these plants, very common type of development of embryo sac is monosporic embryo sac. Why we are calling monosporic embryo sac? In these plants, embryo sac development occurs from one functional megaspore. That's why it is called monosporic development of embryo sac or polygonum type of embryo sac. Here you have to remember one point. Why I am specifying monosporic in some of the plants? Bisporic, tetrasporic is there. Okay, in this one monosporic. Mono means what? Only one spore is, only one megaspore is involved for the formation of embryo sac. In some of the plants, two functional megaspores. In some plants, 4 megaspores are involved for the formation of embryo sac. That's why here I am using monosporic. Monosporic type of embryo sac in which only one functional megaspore is involved. Okay, that's all. Generally here, depending on the number of megaspores involved in the development of embryo sac, the embryo sacs are classified into 3 types. One is already here, monosporic development. This is commonly seen in polygonum. Not only polygonum, 70% of angiosperms, 70% of the angiosperms shows monosporic type of embryo sac. That means what? 70% of the angiosperms produces embryo sac from only one functional megaspore. Okay, that's all. Second type of embryo sac is bisporic. Bisporic. Third one is tetrasporic. Bisporic means what? 2 functional megaspores are involved in the formation of female gametophyte, that is embryo sac. This is commonly seen in Allium. Okay, come to the point. Okay, bisporic. alien sepa. In this one, the embryo sac is formed from two functional megaspores. It is one functional megaspore. Totally four megaspores are formed, I said. Three degenerate, only one functional, I said. In some plants, out of four, two degenerate, two are involved for the formation of embryo sac. Such kind of embryo sac is called bisporic embryo sac. Example, alien sepa. Tetrasporic, the word itself saying the significance. Tetra means four. In some of the plants, four megaspores are involved for the formation of embryo sac. Such type of embryo sac is called tetrasporic embryo sac. Example, lilium. So this is embryo sac classification. Okay, so depending on the number of megaspores are involved for the formation of embryo sacs. Okay, so the plants are classified into like this way. Embryo sacs are classified into like this way: monosporic embryo sac, bisporic embryo sac, tetrasporic embryo sac. So this classification is done by the scientist Panchanan Maheshwari. Panchanan Maheshwari. In 1950. Okay, that's all. This is called megasporogenesis and female gametophyte. Megasporogenesis and female gametophyte. Next one is, see here. Next topic, development of an embryo sac. See here, one functional megaspore. In some of the plants, only one functional megaspore is involved. In some, two megaspores. In some plants, four megaspores. See here, one functional megaspore. One functional megaspore. This is called one functional megaspore. It undergoes mitosis divisions and produces two-celled embryo sac. Okay, this one nucleus, one functional megaspore, undergoes mitosis divisions and forms two cells. It is again undergoes mitosis divisions and forms four cells. This four-celled megaspore undergoes another mitosis divisions and forms eight cells. This is called two-celled embryo sac. Embryo sac dyad. Two-celled embryo sac. It undergoes mitosis division and gives four cells. It is called embryo sac tetrad. It undergoes mitosis divisions and forms eight haploid celled embryo sac. When eight cells are formed, eight celled means what? Eight nuclei are formed. Around the nuclei, cell wall is formed. Around the nuclei, cell wall is formed. Soon after finishing mitosis divisions, around the eight celled nuclei, cell wall is formed. Among those eight cells, four cells are moved towards chalazal end. This is called chalazal end. Remaining four cells moved towards micropylar end. In such a way, totally eight celled embryo sac is formed. It is immature form. Okay, see here. This is called embryo sac. From this embryo sac, out of four cells, one haploid cell is moved to center. One haploid cell is moved to center. Another haploid cell is moved to center. Okay, so then these are called polar nuclei. Polar nuclei, these are called polar nuclei. 1, 2, 3, these are called antipodals. 1, 2, 3, these are called one egg, two synergids. So from the 8-celled embryo sac, one cell is moved to center. From this direction, one cell moved to center. These are called polar nuclei. Immature embryo sac contains polar nuclei. So these three cells are gradually turned to be antipodals. So those are in embryo sac seems to be 1, 2, 3. Three antipodals. Haploid, 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 antipodals. Antipodals. Here, egg cell. One, two. These are called synergids. Those are called synergids. So these two polar nuclei, like this way. So in an immature stage, these are called polar nuclei. When embryo sac matured, these two are combined. It is a haploid, it is a haploid. Haploid, haploid, togetherly called diploid. Secondary nucleus. Secondary nucleus. Secondary nucleus. Okay, that's all. This is called embryo sac. This is the development of embryo sac. The mature embryo sac in angiosperms contains 8 haploid cells. Though those are 8-celled, 7-celled nuclei. 7-celled nuclei. Why? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In immature, 8-celled. A typical angiosperm embryo sac contains, though 8-celled, 7-celled nuclei are present. When it is born, 8 cells are there. Though it was 8-celled, at the time of maturity, a typical angiosperm contains 7-celled cells, 7-celled embryo sac. This is called development of an embryo sac. Okay, that's all. This is an important topic for 5 marks. So these are all the diagrams you have to draw and represent. These are all the parts. So here, about this already first PUC I said it. Okay, so it is egg. Day after tomorrow again it comes, but here also I have to give explanation. So haploid egg is combined with the haploid male gamete. During pollen germination, pollen tube were formed. Pollen tube carries 2 male gametes. One male gamete is fused with the egg and forms zygote. It is called first fertilization. Okay, that's all. Next, here see, this is one egg cell. Fertilization over. Next, one more male gamete is fused with another secondary nucleus, 2n. So 3n triploid nucleus. This is called primary endosperm nucleus. Primary endosperm nucleus gradually turned to be endosperm. So this is called first fertilization. This is called second fertilization. In angiosperms, double fertilization is very common. Okay. So these two are called synergids. Inside the synergids, there is a finger-like structures. There is a finger like structures. Those finger like structures are called filiform apparatus. Filiform apparatus. There is a finger like structures. Those are called filiform apparatus. Those filiform apparatus guide the pollen tube to enter inside of the ovule. Inside of the ovule. Okay, that's all. This is called development of an embryo sac. How pollen tube guides, how these filiform apparatus guides the pollen tube, that is what again we will see on fertilization topic. Pollination. See, transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of a flower is called pollination. Generally, pollen grains are immobile. Pollen grains are immobile. So, when they are shed from the anther, they are reached to the stigma by various means, what? Various types of agents. Those agents may be water, insects, birds, wind, etc. Those agents are biotic agents or abiotic agents, living agents, non-living agents. Okay, that is called pollination. Depending on the means of pollen transfer, pollination is of two types. Self-pollination. Self-pollination and cross-pollination. First of all, self-pollination. Everybody knows that. In this one, transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of a same flower or different flower born on the same plant is called self-pollination. The self-pollination is again two types. Autogamy. Autogamy, getanogamy. Autogamy. Auto means self. Gamy means marriage. Self-marriage. In this type of pollination, the flower must be bisexual. Anther and carpel, both are must be located on same flower. In those flowers, autogamy occurs. It refers to the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of a same flower. To perform autogamy, the flower must be a bisexual flower. That is called autogamy. Example, wheat, rice, and pea plant. In them, it is happens. Wheat, rice, pea plants. In them, autogamy occurs. Getanogamy. See here, getan means neighbors. Gamy means marriage, neighboring marriage. With neighbors, marriage happens. In this one, transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of different flower born on the same plant. That is called getanogamy. Getanogamy. Okay, so that's all. So in this one, any extra agencies are not required. Just wind or water current. So pollen grains are reached to the stigma of another flower born on the same plant. That is called getanogamy. Okay, that's all. This is the pollination. Its continuation. Next class we will see that.